Good morning and hello everybody, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Pokemon Blue with our Gen 1 type challenge of Flying type. We are finishing up Route 11 to start off this episode, and then we're going to go clear out Fiesta Sand and take on Lieutenant Surge. Hope everybody is doing well this morning. Alright, and our whole team is at level 23, and the reason again that we're using Aerodactyl is Aerodactyl is not really good at using against all those water types in the lower part of the SSN. So we're going to level him up first before we switch back over to Doduo and Farfetch'd. Good deal, Aerodactyl. All right. Well, Doduo's pretty low. We'll switch up Farfetch'd. We only have a couple trainers left anyways. Farfetch'd has recently learned Swords Dance. Oh, he leveled up already. Swap back up Doduo for this last trainer who's got the Ekans. If we get to a bad point, we can always drop a potion on him. Right. Onto the boat we go. Sorry, ooh. Guess I'm still waking up just a bit. Good deal, Doduo. Or Fury Attack. Good stab on that, just like Farfetch'd did. Oof. That was a hard hit, Doduo. Looks like three got it less than half, so if we can do that again, we should be able to knock it out. Good deal, Doduo. Oh my goodness, why am I yawning so much? I'm sorry. I've been up for over an hour, I've had coffee. I really should be fine. We'll just let Doduo finish out this fight. Not who I wanted to switch up. That's the TM for rest. We'll just let Aerodactyl know it for now. We can always get rid of it later. Alright, good level up. Go away, Shellder. Might as well just drop a Super Ondo Duo so we don't have to leave and come back to keep clearing out the ship. Alright, let's head the other direction. We have the couple trainers out here on the deck that we will take on. All right, another one here. Ah, Shellder. Such high defense. Of course, I guess he just keeps using withdraw. It's not like we're gonna take any damage. Just gonna take us more hits to knock him out. Right. I know this guy has water Pokemon, but I think he's just got like Goldeens, and Goldeens don't learn Water Gun, I don't think, early on. Even if they do, we should be able to knock it out pretty quick with Aerodactyl. So everyone getting to 25? Yeah, we'll just keep Tentacool up front. Now, I'm pretty sure this gentleman up here has a Pikachu, which Aerodactyl is not good against, because flying types are not good against electric types. So we will swap. Good deal, Doduo. Alright, this is the last room of trainers. This guy's got fire types, he's got the Growlithe and the Ponyta. And this one's got a Rattata and a Pikachu, if I remember correctly. One more, what a done it, Doduo. Well, at least it used Quick Attack and not Thunder Shock. Sand attack. Missed the disable. Good paralysis. All right, SSN cleared. We'll get cut. I did get the bike voucher already, didn't I? Yeah. Honestly, couldn't remember. It was like 3 days ago. Toot toot. Drop off some items. Start looking while we clear out these trainers. These Pikachus are fast. That doesn't bode well for Raichu, because it's probably going to be really fast. And then a critical hit on top of that. Yeah, just in time to see us fight Surge, Al. You're right. Strap in. Because it's going to be tough. We're going to have to really buckle down on strategy here. I don't ever really mind Sonic Boom. When it does almost a 30 your health, though, that's not really ideal. Good critical. One more time would have knocked him out, though, Doduo. Yeah, Sonic Boom's good early game, but really loses its effect late game. Alright, good deal with the door at least. Well, Seismic Toss does level, Nightshade does level, Dragon Rage does flat 40, and I think that's the only set damage moves apart from Sonic Boom, which does a flat 20. Psywave does a random amount from 1 damage to your level times 1.5 damage. So it is random. It doesn't adhere to type, but it is still random damage. So you can't ever guarantee what it's going to do. Alright, here we go with Lieutenant Surge. This is probably going to be... bad. I really think we're gonna have a tough time with this because Thunderbolt is gonna hit any of these Pokemon like a truck. Oh, wait, I actually wanted to use. Don't knock it out, Doduo. Don't knock it out. Don't knock it out. I may have just messed up, like, terribly. Because I thought he sent out his Voltorb first. I was not paying attention, honestly. Alright, Farfetch'd, I need you to weather a few Thunder Shocks. Okay, you can do that, that's good. Well, ideally we hit it first, but I think Raichu's gonna beat us speed-wise. Yeah, and I think we're just gonna get knocked out here. I really fucked up. You missed. I think we just die here. I honestly don't see any way out of this. we're gonna do like no damage with wing attack. I think this is just a loss. I could rest, but he sleeps for two turns then, and then we're just in a perpetual rest cycle. Charizard can learn Dig because Charmeleon can learn Dig. Alright, well, since that was completely my fault the way I messed up there, so let's try again. Or are we healed? Does it automatically heal us? It does. Okay. So the correct thing to do in that fight, which I didn't do, was to start out with Farfetch'd. The fact that I didn't start out with Farfetch'd was the mistake. Because I was supposed to set up on his Voltorb and then crush through the rest of his team. But me, being in the hurry that I was not paying attention and let Doduo knock it out with a single Fury attack. That was the mistake. So let's try this the way I actually planned. Yeah, Charizard can learn quite a few ground attacks. I do remember that. Alright, we can take a couple screeches, that's fine. Alright, Farfetch'd, we're counting on you here. Oh, and he used the next speed! What an idiot! That's the win. Oh no, Farfetch'd is going to be the MVP early game now that he learned Swords Dance at 23. Farfetch'd will definitely be the weak link late game. nobody can learn Thunderbolt. Yeah. All right. I think that first loss was completely my fault for just the way I screwed up there. I knew immediately as soon as I did it, I was like, rut-row. Rut-row, Raggy. This is not looking good. I use Visual Boy Advance M. Alright. At this point, I don't really think it matters who we use. You know, the trainers that are going to take the longest now are going to be the hikers with the rock Pokemon, because we don't have any moves that are good against rock types, so we're just going to be banging our heads against them until they knock themselves, or until they get knocked out. Alright, there goes this trainer. And we'll let the headbanging commence. Oh, gross. Is he just gonna keep using Bind? And remember, the reason we stack up agilities is so we can try to raise our critical hit chance even higher. Good call. Always crit on the final hit. Aw, we got burned? No way. The thing that sucks with burns is burns, like, drop your attack. have any burn heals. Well, I was going to use Doduo to fight these Beedrills, but I'm not now with the burn on them. And this is how you have to get back. You have to go past this trainer in order to get back to Cerulean to heal. Alright, we need to swap Aerodactyl up for this next hiker. That's kind of what I was hoping that Geodude would do. What do you think, Al? I'm gonna have another crit on the final hit. Ah, 5-hit bind. Waste years of my life, Onyx. Well, there's crit early. Oh my goodness. Another bind attack. We're speeding this up. I'm not gonna wait 5 years for 20 binds. good level up. Well, even at the Elite Four, we'll still be at the same level or lower than the Elite Four. I mean, it's going to be tough. Lorelei is going to be tough. You know, and Bruno's Onyxes and our rivals Rhydon. I have a plan for those late game rock types. The rival starter was a Charmander. Doduo, you need to stop getting status effect. Oh my goodness. Why would Squirtle be a bad time? Because of Aerodactyl? Does his Blastoise no Blizzard late game? Weef. Blizzard would have been bad, yeah. I mean, he's still gonna have Gyarados. And Gyarados isn't horrible comparatively. Really, our biggest threat's gonna be the Rhydon. I'm not looking forward to the Rhydon. There's a rock throw. I was wondering when we were going to start seeing them, because even on Aerodactyl, they'll do neutral damage. This Geodude is not high enough level to know self-destruct. He learns that at level 21, sadly, so we will not see him doing that against us, which really is the ideal move we want to see them do against Aerodactyl. Rock throw is bad. Rock throw is dangerous for us. Yeah, Horndrew won't be the issue. It doesn't not know Rock Slide? I thought it knew Rock Slide. If it only knows Fury Attack, that's a little sad. Weak. Well, there was a critical, but not enough to knock it out. It's funny that we are the only people then that can know rock slide, being that you get it from a TM. You know who knows rock slide? That little girl on top of the Celadon department store's Pokemon. They all know rock slide and Tri-Attack and Ice Beam. Plot twist, she is the champion. Yeah, everyone plays for second place. It's really final boss, the little girl on top of the Celadon department store. Why do you think she's got all these TMs to hand out? Fight me! I don't care, sure. Do a spoiler for Sword and Shield. Good deal, Doduo. Heal again. So I'm gonna save. Oh yeah? That sounds fun. That's kind of like is it Black and White that you go fight Cynthia again? Or is it Diamond and Pearl? I can't remember. That's like really difficult with her Garchomp and her Spirit Tomb and her Milotic and all that stuff. We're gonna end the episode here. So we will be back tomorrow with streams. I have to go on into my office a little early this morning. So hope you all have a great rest of your day, and we'll see you tomorrow. Take care, everybody.